Welcome to South Africa. This is where we spent the first night after about 36 hours of traveling. This little restaurant we're in. We still have about 2 hours to go before we get to the job site in Dopini. Our fearless leader over there. So we're going to have coffee and devotion.
Several people later.
And we'll head to Dopini. Friday morning.
First thing is what we're going through today. Benefits of the struggle that you may be fully developed. Overcoming obstacles is what develops us, develops the qualities in us we need to fulfill God's will in our lives. Truth is, it can't happen any other way. In 2 Corinthians chapter 1, Paul spells out the benefits of going through our times. Yes, there are actually benefits. Let's take a moment to look at the other devotion I want to talk to you about this morning. It comes out of Proverbs, and it's about the virtuous wife. You can call her blessed. We all, in one point, we may not have spouses, but the one thing we have in common, we all have a mother. So this can relate to whatever influence that person has in your life.
A major earthquake has hit Japan on Friday afternoon.
Happening live.
The meteorological agency says the earthquake measured magnitude 8.4. The earthquake hit about an hour and a half ago. Your occupancy seats.
One of the local drivers. We found it. We're going to carry him along with us. Let's see if he'll work. Get on it.
37.
ridges out, so we have to make our own way around. Kind of like Honduras at one time. Try not to hit all the holes, man. It's hard to hold this camera still.
Spray paint.
And then tell him, yeah, spray paint.
This must be it. Well, looky there, Jerry.
Just a little bit.
Well, we finally made it to where we're going to be staying.
This year's the hard way.
I got a pretty little eye for him.
We're out in the country.
Okay.
And we're on our way to the job site.
Yeah, we're keeping that town. That's where the job site is. The little town right
here. So, what do you want to do with the site? It's a Mozambique.
Still.
back over there.
You going to carry on this side?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because I got tired of the last time.
Yeah, yeah, after, I figured, man, I don't wait much.
After talking to you, I think I'm going to come back and drill a well. You said all I had to do is stand here and watch.
Worse and worse places.
Baltimore.
Yeah, we're
out of the Baltimore. It's the next one. It's not this building, it's the next one, isn't it?
Next one, yeah. This is going to be the church. We're working on the next one now.
Oh, and you already got a cross up there.
Look at that. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I built that cross. Moretti wood.
Now, but is that a design, Robin's design for the homer?
No, I did this before y'all.
Oh, before we did that last one?
Before y'all came.
I'm right here in Rockville.
Is that anybody?
Yeah. Look at all these people out here working. Never seen them.
We're not in Mokopane anymore. I'm going to tell y'all something. These mamas that are out here working, every one of them are HIV positive.
Wow.
And they get sick and they have to go sit down every once in a while, but they're doing the best they can.
Here we go.
We on the park. Just straight on up, let there be fine.
They're already out here working.
They're waiting.
Wait on us.
Man, I hope we're doing the lane block. We ought to be able to knock this out in 2 days.
Well, we're going to get started. This is what we're going to start with. Now this is what we're going to start with. We should be able to block this up. It's already started, got the footings in, some of the blocks in. Where are they coming right on up with it? Friday afternoon. Hey, Jerry. What do you think? Well, we're almost at a block. Job. first day on the job. Well, I told you guys it was going to be different, didn't I? This is the kitchen and our cook.
She has 4 yard deep.
So what, Tammy, what, tell us what we're having.
We're having tacos.
Tacos, all right.
A good old South African dish.
Tacos.
Everybody loves tacos.
How's that, and the cheese? And that's rice in the pot.
You can get, why don't you start off with two?
Two, here you go, Jerry.
Yeah, you'll be ready.
I touched it.
Wait, oh yeah, I know.
Oh, I didn't know. We start off at four, and you just end up with
nothing. We're down now. I mean, there's more shells.
Is this rice or?
No, oh, that's cheese. The cheese. Oh, I'm going to burn this.
Yeah, it's Mexican rice here.
This is the Mexican rice. You're being all technical. I'm going to use my hand.
Well, that's all right.
We're getting it done. This is only a day and a half's worth of work. It's about 4 o'clock in the afternoon on the second day of work. And as you can see, we got a lot done. Little kids, they won't come up here. That's Sunday morning. I'm trying to level this floor out.
Are we level yet?
Are we there yet?
By then it's too late. I don't have. We'll just. I think Petro's come back and pour. I was sure hoping to get it poured. Well, that's why I went to town yesterday, was to get two mixers.
Yeah. That's the church over there on the other lot adjacent to the shelter that we're building.
Every 7 years,
they got to use for all of it. But they, you know, they're really good at that well. They're cutting up and not cutting everything all at one time.
Get it pretty close.
the way to church.
Roads like this one, I wish I had my truck.
Yeah.
It's like a four-wheel drive. Go. Now we're ahead of home, right?
Yeah.
We need to send some pictures of us at church to pastor so he can show them on Sunday.
Yeah.
Man, this is a
real good. We're still on the way to church. Yep, we're on the way to church. I don't think they call it.
Jim, don't feel danger though.
They picked up a rider.
He's here from
Carolina. They have three days out. I know that Jeff Beverly said they get
downhill. Let me walk.
Man, Walter been pushing.
Let that driver take pictures around the drive.
Get a cell phone. Need to text him.
About half of them did a pretty shitty job site.
Yep. We're still on the way to church.
Somehow that video camera doesn't quite capture this.
No.
Real true.
What, I just about go anywhere with David. As long as he's driving, I get to sit back and relax.
David will be wore out.
He gets his back and the first thing we do is put a shovel on his head.
Yeah.
No respect.
Go down to Carmen.
He's down there.
Man, that engine.
That's the strange thing.
We're still on the way to church.
That parking is still a problem.
Yes. We're walking church, you think?
Uh-huh, there's the church. We are at the church.
You turn in right there, Dave? Or maybe you did that to make it easier to get out.
They even have a traffic director. Look at there.
Some parking ministry. His parking ministry.
Well, we're at church.
When Jesus opened the door, bless me. When Jesus bless me.
Sunday morning. We're at church. This is a little area that this church services, little community. Typical of the area around here. There's the church. Beautiful, picturesque. Church. David. Well, we're going to head back to work pretty soon. Petros. And one of the baboons. They're all over the place. right there. They're watching us eat.
That's the one with the crooked tail.
Hey, buddy. Hey. Michelle. Come here.
Oh, there's a reason.
Land for you. Yeah. As soon as you come underneath.
Sunday afternoon, we're having lunch with the monkeys.
Yeah, there's a big one right there. A big old white one.
What are these now? White-faced baboons?
Yeah, I thought about being one of the freaks. But you know, it was the baboons that got in.
And Sunday afternoon, we're having a lunch before we go back to work. Just had church service.
Their door was open.
It wasn't open. It was shut.
Sunday afternoon, we're back on the job. The cows are going home. Mixing the mud for the footings on the inside of the building. Sunday afternoon. Preaching earlier today, Petros. Done.
Getting here, working here in South Africa. I can't count how many trips this is on me right now, but this means a lot to me in a lot of ways. There's sacrifices that I make to come here. My family makes some sacrifices, my wife Debbie at home, and God allows me to come every year that I need to come. And this morning, this young man here, Petros, had a sermon, and it was God-given, if not anybody but for me. And I thank God that I came on this trip this year. It's a beautiful country. I recommend it to young people in our church, if they would just get involved and apply themselves to let God use them. Because we need young people in this group, and welcome them. So I'd come every year if I could. God sends me when he wants me to be here.
Thank you, Alton.
Thank you, guys.
Go back to work.
I didn't do it.
Tell me what this trip means to you.
Oh, man.
What our team means to you, what MAPS means to you.
I couldn't survive without MAPS. Everything we do depends on MAPS teams coming over. And this team's one of my favorite ones I've ever worked with. They work harder and faster than any other team we've ever had. And so we love Evangel, and well, thank you for sending them, and we couldn't do it without y'all. We hope you come back every year to South Africa.
I want you to tell me what this trip has meant to you, Rex.
It's solidified that God knows what he's doing, even with the weakest of us. He can accomplish most anything. Him be the glory.
What do you think about MAP? What do you think about our...
That's the best relationship for men that we've got in the church. We just need to grow more, to come on a trip, that we hook for life.
I want you to tell me what this trip and what MAP means to you.
Well, the first trip I went on changed my life. Whole different world. It makes you appreciate your family, home, country, everything the Lord gives, all he's done for us. Beyond what you can describe in words.
Appreciate it. Uh-huh. Appreciate you.
Thank you. All right.
There's Dan from California. Dan.
Yes, sir.
Tell me what these kind of trips mean to you. Tell me who you are. Nobody at home knows who you are.
Well, I'm Dan from California. We're signed up to be missionary associates for 2 years. So you can meet Charles and Jack here and get to work hand in hand with these guys. And I tell you what, these projects are awesome. It's great to come out here and go to church with these people and get to see worship. Worship out here is something else. And if you do these churches, I can't express the joy you get.
Petros, tell me what, briefly, what these kind of trips, what kind of these projects mean to you?
Here in Dublin, serving the Lord, everything is going well. Everything is for his glory, no man's glory. We're enjoying ourselves. I really love to do this because it's what God has given to me, and I give it back to you. Thank God for you.
Amen. Thank you.
And a wonderful team that is around with you very hard.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
What do you think about these MAP trips and the mission field and so forth?
Oh, man, I love the MAP trip. Wouldn't trade it for nothing in the world. Man, it's a privilege to be in South Africa and to see the kids and to see what God's doing and to know that we're a part, even if it is a small part, in what God's doing down here. The harvest of souls, the people who are just wonderful, they're lovely, they love God, and there again, it's just a privilege and an honor to be down here and to be a part of what God's doing.
Amen. Thank you very much, David. Tell me what you think about this trip, about being on a MAP trip in Africa and all your other experiences, maybe.
Love just doing the work for the Lord.
Just tell me what you think about MAPS and the trips and so forth.
MAPS is definitely my heart. It has been for many, many years, and I hope it continues to be the same. I love God. I love working on missions. Wouldn't do anything that I could enjoy any more than I do missions work.
There you go. Hey, Adam. Adam, I know that this is your first trip, first missions trip. Tell me what you think so far.
I love it. I love building and doing stuff for the Lord. I mean, it says to go out to all nations and spread the word, and that's what I'm trying to do, going out and spreading the word. This is my first building trip. I've been on two regular trips that we went and just did Bible studies and stuff, and I love it. I mean, we wouldn't want to do nothing else.
Hey,
Hey, Jared, go ahead and put that down a second. Tell me what you think about the mission field and maps and so forth.
Well, I just absolutely love doing this. You get close to the people you work with. You get to travel the world. You get to see how people live in other parts of the world, what God's really doing with other people in the world. It's just a blessing to me. And I hope I get to do it the day I die.
Thank you, Terry.
All right, sir.
How many trips have you been on?
This is my 10th trip.
10th trip, wow.
My first one was in China.
China, wow.
Yeah, the experience of a lifetime. I've never been around so many people like that in all my life. The different ways of religion, the Buddhist, everybody worships in a different way. And, you know, I always thought Christianity was worldwide, but it's not. And it means a lot to go into these countries and be a part of Christianity, spreading the word.
Amen. Here we are in the continent of Africa. So you've been from China to Africa.
I've been all over the world. Been all over South America, Bolivia, Argentina, Guatemala. I can't think of all of them.
That's good.
And it's so different. People are so poor and we're so blessed, and we really don't realize that until we go on one of these trips. When I get home, I just thank God that He let me be born in America, where I'm free to worship the way I feel.
Amen.
And how the luxuries of life.
This is Pastor Keith. He's hard at work. Hey, Keith, let's step around the corner a second. What do you think of this is your first real mission trip, building trip. What do you think?
My construction trip.
Right.
It's a lot more harder than I anticipated it. Muscles are sore and I'm tired. But it's been real good. Enjoyed it.
Great. Hey, Bill.
Hey.
Stop for a minute. Come here. Tell me what you think about the MAPS program at Evangel and how it's done over the years and so forth.
The MAPS program at Evangel is one of the most significant mission traditions, if nothing else, that we have going on. I think it's one of the longest running as far as a lay-led ministry. And it's like my highlight of the year, is getting to go with the MAPS and do something. I want to thank Jack Temple for keeping it alive.
So, how many trips have you been on?
Oh, goodness. Six or seven, I guess. Maybe eight. When it comes to MAPS, what I've learned is that putting up the building of the structure is only part of what we do here. Being able to touch the lives, being able to share the things in common that we have with people around the world. Sometimes, I guess, in the States, we feel like that we kind of got this exclusive thing to take. But I mean, when I go to church with these people, we got nothing on them other than we can help them continue on what they're doing. We're empowering the local people to reach their own people, and that's a lot more effective than us trying to be everywhere. So I think it's a wonderful idea, wonderful thing that we're doing.
How much more effective?
Right,
it's different. Possibly be because of
the power and the people. Hey, Glenn, come here.
Well, I just love it. I love to come and visit other countries and do the Lord's work. And it's just an overwhelming experience to me to be able to do this and meet people and see places I've never seen before and meet people I've never met before. It's just an awesome feeling to me, and I love the Lord, and He's using me to do this, and I like it.
Amen. How many MAPS trips have you been on?
This is my seventh.
Seventh trip, wow. Okay, yep. Good. Do you remember your first trip?
Yes, it was to Argentina.
Wow, great.
Yep.
One of my favorite places, Argentina. What did you think of it?
Argentina was fun. It was a good trip. Yeah. It was different than any other ones that I've been on, but it was a good one. We're kind of doing a remodel job there instead of building from the ground up.
Good deal. All right, Glenn, you go back to work.
Okay.
All right.
All right, guys. Hey, you always gonna take me back to work.
Tell me your name.
My name is Enoch.
Aha. Uh-huh. And you're the pastor's son, Pastor Jeremiah's son, right?
Yeah, I'm the son of Pastor Jeremiah.
Uh-huh. So what do you think of what we're doing here?
Oh, we are here to, we are building this project, really.
Okay, what is this project for?
Oh, this structure's gonna be used for those people who are vulnerable by diseases, like those who have HIV, AIDS, TB, and those orphans. So they will be helped after this finishing of building. They will be coming in here, you know, getting some knowledge about how can they live, you know, how can they live whereas they are hopeless, you know. The knowledge, that knowledge will bring the hope back to them.
Yeah. Amen. And what about the salvation message of Jesus Christ?
So, yeah. And then, obviously, because my dad is pastor, she's going to minister, you know, the word of God to those people who are vulnerable, to those people who are homeless, so that they will feel that Jesus Christ, even though those people, they don't have parents, they don't have any assistance, but God or Jesus Christ is going to help them. It's going to be, it's going to be them. He's going to be the one who will show them how can they live a abundant life in this world, whereas they are living under a bad situation.
Well, we sure thank you for helping us today.
Okay, thanks you.
Okay, God bless you.
You too. Okay, my pastor.
Amen.
All right.
What are you doing, DJ? What are you doing?
Having stone wars.
Having stone wars?
And here come the opponents.
Oh, wow. You guys be careful.
Yeah, that's gone out the window.
That's DJ. That's Charles's little boy. Guys are hurling rocks at each other. Well, this is where we're going to put the Bible.
It was a great honor when Jack asked me to dedicate this to Royce Johnson. As many of you guys know, Royce has been on many of our trips with us. Matter of fact, if it wasn't for Royce, we may not even have MAPSA right now, because he was one of the original founders of it. And to dedicate it to a man like that, not only was he one that believed in MAPS, but like Pedro said, he used the talents that God gave him to do what he could do. I mean, he pushed MAPS, he pushes missions, and he believes in those kind of things. Matter of fact, when I visited him in the hospital not too long ago, some of you guys that don't know that they had to medically induce sleep on him, but as soon as he woke up, he started telling people about Jesus. Mm-hmm. And he's got four or five people starting to come to church now, and he's not even able to come to church simply because he loves Jesus with all of his heart. And so to dedicate a building like this that's going to be used to spread God's word and to show the love of God, I think it is just amazing. Right now, I'm going to have Brother Rex come up here, and I want each one of you, and I thought about this late last night. Let's put just grab a little piece of the Bible, and Brother Rex is going to lead us in prayer before we actually put it in. Because like Bill said yesterday, kind of we were talking about it, and he said, you know, we don't know what this building is going to be used for 20 or 30 years from now, but we know that God's Word is involved in it. And so Brother Rex.
The Heavenly and Gracious Father, Lord, we just thank you for this opportunity that you've blessed each of us with. And Lord, we just plant your word in this foundation, Lord, that this building from now on would be blessed by you, Lord, for your glory and your praise. Lord, that no matter what the years ahead bring, that anything that steps into this building would be blessed by you, Jesus. Lord, anoint it in a special way, Father. We just give you the praise and the glory and the honor for it. For it's in the precious name of Jesus that we do dedicate it and ask your covering. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
pastor's office, by the way, that this is going to be next to. Great, great. Thank you so much. Back to work. Well, it was Monday morning, around 10:30, and we've been at it for a while. Dedicated the building to Royce Johnson for all of his years of dedication to MAPS. Very fitting honor. The Mud Men. They the glue that holds that whole building together. Monday morning, about 10:30. I had to burn off a little brush this morning. David, man, he's been hard at it. Starting on the interior walls, it looks like. Looking good. Well, this is the end of, it's Monday afternoon, and we're finishing up for today. And we got quite a bit done on the inside. We really didn't expect to do that. Got some finish up on the side and then on the front. We're gonna try to brick it up, aren't we, Jerry? Yep.
Have it enclosed and then they'll be where they can bring some people.
That's good,
y'all. The end of the work day on Monday. We've got one more day to go tomorrow. We're loading up.
I'm gonna take a daily picture anyway.
Well, I thought we were loading up. Now we're loading up. Cleaning up, headed home. Well, headed back to the hotel. Gonna try to finish the front end of this tomorrow. Come the goat. Well, this is where we're leaving it. The end of the workday on Monday, got one more day to go. Gonna work on that tomorrow in the front end and hopefully we'll have it all blocked up. Tuesday morning. We had quite a shower last night. Hopefully that bridge not washed out that we've got to come across. But these are the cabins we're staying in. First chance I've had to really do anything but video. So our leader. Good morning.
Morning.
What happened last night?
I don't know what happened.
You don't know what happened?
A lot of noise on my roof, though.
I can see it on the ground. Look at that. I hear that river raging back there.
Yeah. I hope we can get out the bridge.
I do, too. There's that funny looking tree. Well, this is where we're staying. These are the cabins that we've been staying in. We have monkeys running and baboons running across the roofs. Beautiful park. Goats. A lot of stuff. They're sure we've been eating dinner right there. Beautiful park. beautiful wildlife refuge. Man, those goats are hollering. Tuesday morning, last day on the job. Well, we're on the way to check out to see whether the bridge is gonna be kind to us today. I've never driven in here this fast.
Seatbelt. This car will tell on you.
Yeah.
Across the bridge. Them all lined up. Should we go or should we wait? Uh-oh.
That don't look good.
Uh-oh.
Nope.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh, that's right. Gonna go down and survey the little bridge down here that we've been having to go across.
Yeah, that blowed out completely.
Well, this is the bridge we normally cross every morning. We used to cross.
Once this guy cross, let's see.
Oh, we got somebody coming across?
Can they walk them?
Oh.
I think they can make it.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know what that car's doing. Just crossed right there. Is that a hole?
There's not a big hole right there, is there?
It looked like it blowed out there.
Wow, look at that. Yeah. Well, we got one going to try to cross it. Made it. Here comes another one. Yeah. All right. In case it gets
we all go to the job site today. Yeah, we are leaving.
That ain't bad.
Yeah, we'll see you next
it's
time.
It's gone down since we were through here. Yeah. It's gone down a lot, Jack.
It sure has.
Not even up to their axle.
Oh, yeah, it's huge, yeah. It ain't nothing but a little trickle now compared to what it was.
Yeah, it was all up in here.
He busted that big rock up right there at the very, yeah. That's what everybody's getting hung up on. Well. Oh. We hadn't had that before, had we?
No.
Ooh.
Not neither.
What are y'all watching you, David?
Don't
stop. Get it. Good gravel here. Good job.
Well, we're on our way.
Somewhere.
Somewhere.
Jerusalem, near the Sheep Gate, a pool, which in Aramaic is called Belshaddai, and which is surrounded by five covered colonnades, have a great number of disabled people used to lie the blind, the lame, the paralyzed. One who was there had been an invalid for 38 years. When Jesus saw him lying there and learned that he had been in condition for a long time, he asked him, "Do you want to get well?" Throughout the Bible of Jesus' times, Jesus tends to ask obvious questions, or what we would seem obvious questions. He asked the blind man, "Does he want to see?" And so here's this paralytic, if you would, that had been there for 38 years, and Jesus goes, "What do you want from me?" In some versions, in the King James Version, it actually says, "What do you want from me?" You would think that'd be a pretty obvious question, wouldn't you? But instead of the guy saying, "Yes, I want to be healed," or "I do want to be healed," and depending on which version you're in, the man doesn't do that. The man actually, in verse 7, says, "Sir," the invalid replied, "I have no one to help me into the pool when the water is stirred. While I am trying to get in, someone else goes ahead of me." Then Jesus said, "Get up, pick up your mat, and walk." What did the guy do? He made excuses of why he can't be healed. He didn't answer Jesus' question of healing. He asked. He answered Jesus with excuses. The devotion actually has come. This is actually part of my Sunday school lesson for this Sunday. And I'm not doing all of it, but just the premise or the thought of it is, how many times does God give us something or ask us a question or reveal a dream to us, and all we do is make excuses of why we can't do those things? I don't have enough money. I don't have this. I don't have that. And Jesus did not listen to the guy's excuses. Jesus just said, "Just get up and walk. I don't want to listen to it. Just go." And the same thing with us and stuff. I mean, there's times where Jesus has told us to do stuff, or he has asked us to do something, put a passion in our heart, and we want to make excuses. "Well, I'm not a good talker," as Moses would say. Or "I'm just a little boy," as David may have given him an excuse. All these little excuses, and Jesus don't want to hear a word.
Well, this is what we got Tuesday morning after the devotion. Looks like it's going to set in for a long day of rain. Wow. Can you do that, Rex?
Dream on. I can't even stand on my head, let alone carry something like that.
is empty. How do you make it stay up there?
There's Eva.
My head's got too much.
She's going to have her office here. Petro. Kind of standing around and waiting on Charles to get here with some material. We got one more little project we got to do. Well, this is for winter. We're going to call that Winter Falls. We're on the way to our place where we're going to stay tonight, and then on into Kruger tomorrow.
Thank you very much for what you have done for the project, because if it was not you, we will remain as we are. Thank you very much, because hundreds of children are going to get shelter. And we still need more from you, because we depend upon you. With the boss, he did a wonderful job. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.